I'm trying to gather some information to work out the average age group of the riders here. Right. So I know this gentleman over here is 89.
Yeah.
I know this gentleman here is 89. I reckon you've got to be 50.
51.
Well, there's Colin, look. On his old Norman motorcycle, or I think it's a Francis Barnett actually. Anyway, the plan is to meet up with some members of the Vintage Motorcycle Club, and then we're going to go out for a ride out with them. Quite where we're going, or what machines they've got, I don't know. But I'll bring you back when we're there. But before we get there, let's just go back in time a little while to when Colin got his lovely restored Excelsior out of the garage. He'd done a great job in restoring this motorbike, and he was so keen on showing it to the world. So here it is, the Excelsior motorcycle.
It's a 1929 Excelsior A2.
Right.
It's a 147cc two-stroke rated at 1.25 horsepower. With a top speed of about 35 miles an hour.
So when you think of the word, the name Excelsior, you think of excellence.
Yes.
Superior.
One of their most famous bikes was the Excelsior Talisman Twin, which was quite a sporty, racy bike.
Yeah.
But they did the Excelsior Manxman, which was another very famous, successful race machine. So yes, a bit like Norton, they had quite a few successes at the TT.
Yeah, yeah.
And this little bike has got quite an interesting story, and we're going to do a video specifically on that machine.
Yeah.
Because one of these machines actually won the lightweight TT back in 1929, and this bike is 1929 and pretty much the same as the TT winning machine.
Yeah, that'd be great. Yeah. And we'll have a ride out on it, won't we?
Definitely.
But today it's staying in the garage because you don't want to get it dirty.
Well, in case it rains today, and also it's only about sort of 30 mile an hour top speed, so it might be a bit slow for today's run.
Yeah, okie doke. Well, there it is, the Excelsior. What can I say? Thank God they don't make them like that anymore.
He often says that.
Well, here we are. We've arrived at the meet-up point, which is Sainsbury's car park at Royal Wootton Bassett, and all the riders are getting themselves ready for their ride out. Looks like we've got an interesting array of bikes, and all teenagers in their day, no doubt. For me, this is one of the most interesting bikes. I've never seen an engine like that, a Triumph engine like that. It's a side valve engine. And this is a Triumph TRW. Apparently, they were used as military bikes. This one was an RAF bike. And unfortunately, a lot of them were cut up and destroyed when they were decommissioned. But this one is still in one piece. There's a bit of foot action going on in front with the guy in front. He's having a few problems with his gear shifts. See if I can nip past a few of them. Well, let's see if I can get past Colin and get a look at this BSA Bantam. A 125 Bantam from the 1950s or the 1960s, I think. So there's the Triumph Thunderbird. What a beautiful bike that is. I've got a feeling the bike in front of me now is the Velocet. Slow down for the horses. Yeah, it's got that lovely thump to it. That's the Velocet thumping along beautifully. Look at that. Let's get us out of that exhaust note. So let's see if we can squirt past the Velocet. A more modern Suzuki, I think this is the GN1, the GN250 in front. Squirt past him. There they go, look, all the old bikes. On the right, over there, over the hedge, big water tower. It'd be interesting to put the drone up around that at some point, so I may have to come back and get that. But very pleasant ride in the countryside. Well, I did go back and film the water tower with the drone, and this is what it looks like from above. It's a very impressive water tower near Breydon. I can't really find out much information about it, but I'll let you have a look at what it looks like from the side. Well, you can see the actual tower itself is supported on these concrete legs. I can't say how tall it is. It's quite an impressive structure. I know that it was built in 1981. A Google search has so far not revealed a great deal of information about it. But obviously a very impressive water tower. That's if you're into those sort of things, of course. From this angle, I'm going to do an orbit, but in the background you can see Breydon Pond. I'll ride past that in a minute. And also you can see the lovely countryside that surrounds the tower. Quite a wooded area in this location. So there you have it, the water tower at Breydon, just off the B4040. Another view of the top as we fly over. Well, in the last clip you saw Breydon Pond in the distance from the drone shot. Well, this road we're riding along now, it takes you right past the pond. It's quite amazing. You've got this lovely wooded area that you ride through, and then all of a sudden you're just about to open out, and it opens out now, and then the pond's on your left. As you can see, it's quite a large body of water. I must say, we have taken in a rather scenic route, very enjoyable. I found a few little lanes and tracks that I haven't been along before. I should imagine the average age of this riding group is probably about 80. Riding, no, probably no, maybe not. Maybe 79.
With all joking aside, I'll tell you what, I take my hat off to these riders. Here they are, some of them are 89 years of age. They're still doing the things they want to do and enjoying life to the full. Fair play.
There's the old red phone box. Most of them have been decommissioned now. Sometimes you find books or defibrillators inside them now, not telephones.
In this clip, one of the 89-year-old riders has enough of the smoke from Colin's machine and decides to overtake.
Yep, he's gone for an overtake. Yep. I think we might have a man down. Do you want to push? Want to push? There we go. Feather set had a bit of a hiccup, but apart from that, I think it's all right.
Well, we managed to get the feather set going again. It went with a few kicks,
And now we're heading along this lovely B road to the end of the journey, I think. I'm following Colin, being smoked out as usual. By his little Villiers two-stroke. We've got a hill, a slight hill now, we're going up. So Colin's going to be slowing down and pumping out a lot of smoke. Look at the springs on that seat. Come on, Colin, you can do it. He's slowing down, he's going even slower.
I know this is a church door, but it's a place called Broadtown, and it's what lies behind the church door which is interesting. On the hill in the distance is a white horse. This is the Broadtown White Horse. And there is a closer look at the horse. The reason why I put it in the video, well, it's the first time I've actually seen it with my own eyes, believe it or not. And we rode past it on the vintage ride on the way to the pub where we had a lovely lunch. Anyway, I hope you enjoy this view of the Broadtown White Horse. I think we're coming into the village of Broadhinton now, and I got a feeling this is virtually where the ride is going to end. Here they are, look. Yeah, there they are, all the young men, look, there they are. All 16 year olds at heart. What's happened then, Colin?
I must have left the stand. I thought I heard something dragging.
Oh, the stand.
If I lift the bike up, you put it underneath.
How's that?
So this is one of the cameras I use, a little GoPro.
Oh, right.
Yeah. So you wouldn't think it's filming.
Long,
no. But anyway, you're 82, yeah. And you do trail riding still?
Yes.
And what bike do you ride then?
A DR350.
DR350. And you're going to come out with me and Colin at some point?
Yes.
That'd be great, wouldn't it? If you don't mind me asking, how old are you then?
81.
81?
Yeah.
So you're one of the youngsters then?
Am I?
You've got to be two of the youngest riders here, haven't you?
Oh, of course, yeah.
He's older than me.
How old are you then?
89.
89?
Yeah, that's
right. Fair play. And yours is?
89 in February.
In February? Oh, 89 in February. You're doing well.
Oh, I've been ridden big bikes, and I had a brand new motor Guzzi after that.
Did you?
750, yeah.
Lovely, yeah. And you're still enjoying your riding, hopefully, for many more years to come?
Hopefully, yeah.
Yeah.
That all depends on the insurance.
It all depends, yeah.
Does the insurance get more expensive as you get older?
I don't really know. No, not a huge amount of difference anyway.
Hi, Brian. Going to have some dinner?
So when you first started riding motorcycles, how long ago was you first riding motorcycles then?
First motorcycle I ever rode on the road, semi-legally, was a 600 BSA sidebar.
All right, how long ago was that then? 1950 something,
yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it would have been, yeah.
It's not a rude question, but did you have to... I guess back in those days, you didn't have to take a bicycle test, did you?
You had to take a test. I mean, I took a car test. Now, when you take a car test, you can ride any bike,
yeah,
as long as you've got an L plate on it.
Okay. So even 1,000 cc's?
Yeah. Well, you couldn't get nowhere near 1,000 cc in those days.
No.
Because you'd have to have a... You'd have to have a... what's it called? Either a Brough.
Yeah, Brough Superior.
Or a Vincent.
Yeah, yeah. But you could have ridden that on an L plate.
Yeah.
Those were the days.
And if you could find a motorway, you could ride on that too, but then you'd have to go to Germany for that.
Oh, lovely, yeah.